Hello everyone, in this Photoshop tutorial we're gonna edit product photos for e-commerce website. In this case we will add sunglasses to a model photo. This tutorial was requested by Abdi Mohamed. These are the sunglasses that we're gonna edit and we're gonna put them on this model photo right here. So first off, let's get rid of these parts here. We'll do it using the Context Aware tool and the Clone Stamp tool. So first off, select the Rectangular Marquee tool, make a selection, right click on it, go to Fill, make sure the contents are Context Aware, press OK, and Photoshop will automatically erase them based on the content that it's around them. We're gonna do the same here. Now for the finishing touches, we will use the Clone Stamp tool, select it. Now, to sample, hold down the Alt key and click wherever you want to sample, just like here, and then just paint. I will cut out the sunglasses from the background using the Pen tool. Just select the Pen tool. Now I will speed up the video. By the way, I have a tutorial on how to use the Pen tool. The link will be down in the description below. Now we are done with the selection. Just click on Make Selection, press OK. Now I'll press Command Ctrl J to duplicate them on a new layer. Let's just erase the whites here. And we are done with the background. Now let's just copy them and paste them on our model photo. Let's transform it by pressing Ctrl Command T or just go to Edit and then Free Transform. I'll lower out the opacity so that you can see what I'm doing. Like this is good. I'm looking at her nose and her eyebrows. Also I'm looking at the way the glasses go to her ears. Now this is good, just press OK. Now I can return the opacity to 100. The first thing that we are gonna do is to create a duplicate of the layer. Just right click on the layer, select duplicate layer. Or just press Command J or Control J in Windows. Now, let's hide this layer here. Now we need to make the sunglasses transparent. And we'll change the blending mode to screen, but as you can see, it doesn't affect the lighter parts that are on the glasses, only the darker. So, what we need to do is just invert the layer so that we can invert the colors of the sunglasses. Just press Command I on a Mac or Control I on Windows. And now, as you can see, the colors are inverted, but we need to make it our original color. So let's get the original color from the duplicate layer that we made. Now, to change the color, we will use the Hue Saturation Adjustment layer, like this. Now, press the Alt key and just hover above the thumbnail of the layer that the sunglasses are. And click so that it affects only the sunglasses. Now we will need to change the color to this one here. From the Hue Saturation, we will play around with the slider and we will need to find the color like this. Now this is the same color. Now just again select the screen blending mode And as you can see, the color is the same, but we lost these parts here. Also, this doesn't look good from here and here. So what we're gonna do is we will get these parts from this layer here, from these sunglasses. Now we'll put them the one beneath the other. So this layer here, we need to show only these parts. So how we're gonna do it is create a layer mask and just invert them. Now with the brush tool selected, select the brush tool. We don't see our sunglasses because we inverted and made a layer mask. Select the brush tool and with the white color selected, just brush over this part. And as you can see, they show up. Now, what we did, from this layer, we are only using the glasses, and this layer here are the other parts. Here the diamonds, this metal parts here, here and here. Now I will deal with both layers. So for here, select the brush tool, and this time with the black color, we will erase some of the things that we don't want. Like for example this. Let's just clear out the whites from. Let's make these holders a little bit transparent. Like this. Now from this layer, we need to erase this part. Just select the eraser tool. Like this. Use this one. Now they look good. Now we will copy this part here and put it here so that it goes towards the ear. I will select the lasso tool. Just make selection. And now I'll copy it by pressing Command C or Control C, or just go to Edit and then copy. Now on the new layer, I will paste it. I'll put it below the two layers. Now with the eraser tool, I will make some adjustments. Now go to Edit and then Transform and then Warp to stretch it out a little bit. Like this, press OK. Now I won't make it darker. I will just grab the eraser tool, make sure the hardness is at 0, and I will erase like this. And now it looks like it goes towards her ear. Like this. Now I don't like these parts here because they are very bright. So what I'm going to do is add a brightness contrast adjustment layer. Hold down the Alt key, hover above the layer thumbnail, click so that it affects only it. And now I will lower the brightness and increase the contrast. Like this. Now for finishing touches, I will select all the layers. You can then by click on the layer and then hold down the Shift key, select all layers. Now press Command J or Control J to make a duplicate of the layers. And just right click on the layers and merge them. And now for the finishing touches, go to Filter and then Camera Raw Filter. And just play around with the sliders however you want. I will lower the exposure. This is the final result. As you can see, this is the before and this is the after. The photo looks really amazing. If you have more Photoshop requests, please share them with me in the comment section below. Comment on what tutorials you want me to make. And this is the tutorial for today. Thanks for watching. If you like the video, press the thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more Photoshop and Lightroom tutorials. Thank you. Bye bye.